Hello students, welcome to our physics class with a new topic, that is optics. It is the branch of physics that deals with the study of nature and propagation of light. Then what is light? Light is the form of energy and is the cause of sensation of sight, or it is the part of electromagnetic spectrum which help us to see various objects. Students, electromagnetic spectrum, that is electromagnetic wave. What is electromagnetic wave? What is the source of electromagnetic wave? How it produce? The total is a different unit. I am here just provide you some hints about electromagnetic spectrum. So, what is electromagnetic spectrum? It is the orderly distribution of electromagnetic wave. Like gamma ray, X-ray, UV ray, visible light, infrared ray, radio wave and microwave and radio wave. It is a completely distribution pattern according to their frequency and wavelength. Here, that wavelength gradually increases. From gamma ray to radio wave, that wavelength gradually increases. It's visible light and its wavelength in between 4000 angstrom to 7000 angstrom. Then light have two nature. One is particle nature, another one is wave nature. Depending upon the nature of light, light have dual nature. One is particle nature, another one is wave nature. Depending upon the nature of light, optics is divided into two main categories. One is ray optics, another one is wave optics. In case of ray optics, we concern with the particle nature and discuss the propagation of light and laws of reflection and refraction. And another category, that is wave optics. Here we concern about the wave nature of light. Okay? And in this topic we discuss about interference, diffraction and polarization. Wave optics we study later. Now we go to ray optics.
Ray optics, it concern with itself particle nature of light and about propagation of light and phenomena of reflection and refraction. Here also we discuss about mirror formula for spherical mirror and refraction of light, laws of refraction, refraction in case of spherical surface, lens maker formula, dispersion of light through prism and optical instrument. In optical instrument, we discuss simple microscope, compound microscope and telescope.
So, what is ray? The straight line path along which the light travels in a medium is called ray. If light travels in a straight line path, that is called as ray. Or the bundle of ray, is called as beam. And beam is three types. One is convergent beam, divergent beam and parallel beam. So what is convergent beam? The beam of light in which diameter of the beam of light gradually decreases in the direction of light. Okay, this one is the diameter of the beam of light. If the diameter of the beam of light gradually decreases along the direction of light, this type of beam is called as convergent beam. Whereas, in case of divergent beam, the diameter of the beam of light gradually increases. Diameter of the beam of light gradually increases along the direction of ray. Okay, this type of beam is called as divergent beam. Whereas in case of parallel beam, all the ray move parallel to each other, and the diameter of the beam is remain same always. This type of beam is called as parallel beam. Now we go to reflection. So what is reflection? When a beam of light falls on a surface, most of the light return to the same medium and some part of incident light may be transmitted or absorbed by the second medium. This phenomena is called as reflection of light. Take as this one is a surface. When a beam of light falls on the surface, some part of the light return to the same medium. Some part may be transmitted and some part may be absorbed by the second medium. But most of the part is returned to the same medium. This phenomena is called as reflection of light. Then reflection is two type. One is regular reflection, another one is diffuse reflection. Then what is regular reflection? If we take that incident beam of light that is parallel to each other, or we say that if we take parallel beam of light after hit the smooth surface, the reflected ray also parallel to each other. This kind of reflection is called as regular reflection. At the point of incident, if we draw normal, this normal also parallel to each other. This type of reflection is known as regular reflection. Now we go to diffuse reflection. If we consider the parallel beam of incident light, and hit the rough surface, after reflection, the reflected ray are not parallel to each other. They are diverges in different direction. They are not parallel to each other. This type of reflection is called as diffuse reflection. And in this case, if we draw normal at the point of incidence, that normal are not parallel to each other. This type of reflection is known as diffuse reflection.
Regular reflection is also known as specular reflection. It occurs in case of smooth surface like mirror, glass surface and water surface. Whereas irregular reflection is known as diffuse reflection. It occurs in rough surface like cloth, paper and dry road. This is one of the best example so which you can understand the regular reflection and diffuse reflection. When a driver is in a wet road moving slowly, whereas it prefer move in a dry road because dry road is a rough surface. The reflected ray diverges in all directions, so we able to see the road clearly. Whereas in case of wet road, what happen? That water fill the irregularities of the road, so it becomes smooth. That wet road behaves as smooth surface. So the reflected rays are parallel to each other. When parallel reflected ray comes, they created glaze. Driver have difficulties due to this glaze. So they prefer dry road and not to prefer in a wet road. Or in wet road, they move slowly.
So students, you remember this? We already did this experiment in our school level, which is very much interesting and also easy to understand. So let's focus on it. Now we go to understand laws of reflection. Take us, this one is mirror, XY, mirror surface XY. AB is the incident ray which is approaches towards the surface. After reflection, the ray which is returned to the same medium, this ray is called as reflected ray. That BC is the reflected ray. At the point of incidence, if we draw perpendicular to the surface, called as normal. Now, the incident ray AB, reflected ray BC and normal at the point of incidence all lie in a same plane. Under second law, the angle between normal to incident ray, that angle is called as angle of incidence, and the angle between normal to reflected ray, that angle is called as angle of reflection. Here the second law proposes that the angle of incident and angle of reflection is always equal. Angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection. And if the incident ray is perpendicular to the surface, take us, this one is the surface of the mirror, and incident ray is perpendicular to the surface. That means incident ray is along with the normal, perpendicular to the surface. In that case, there is no deviation occur. That reflected ray is also returned to the same direction, Now we go to, if two plane mirror makes an angle theta with each other, then how many number of images are formed? First one, students, here we take two plane mirror. Take us this plane mirror M1 and this plane mirror take us M2. If this two plane mirror makes an angle theta with each other, okay, then take that object in between two plane mirror, theta 1 is equals to theta 2. At that condition, object is said to be, that object is in symmetric position. If theta 1 equals to theta 2, object is in symmetric position. But if theta 1 is not equal to theta 2, that says that object is at asymmetric position. In that case, theta 1 is not equal to theta 2. Now we go to different case. First one, if two plane mirror makes an angle theta with each other, okay, then we first take the 360 degree divided by theta. If 360 degree by theta is an even number, 360 degree by theta is an even number, then how many number of images form due to this two plane mirror? That is 360 degree by theta minus 1. This one is the formula. Take us one of the example. Take us, if we consider two plane mirror M1 and M2, and in between two plane mirror theta equals to 60 degree. That means two plane mirror makes an angle 60 degree with each other. Then how many number of images form? That is 360 degree by theta. That is 360 degree by 60 degree. This one is the even number. So how many number of images form? That number of images form, that is number of images formed, that is 360 degree by theta minus 1. That means 360 degree by theta, that is 6. 6 minus 1 equals to 5. 5 number of images formed. Next, go to another case. If 360 degree by theta is an odd number, if 360 degree by theta is an odd number, in that case, two case arises. If object is at symmetric position, if object is at symmetric position, that means theta 1 equals to theta 2, then that formula, that is 360 degree by theta minus 1. And if object is at asymmetric position, then that is 360 degree by theta. Here we go to one example, that if two plane mirror makes an angle 40 degree with each other, the theta equals to 40 degree. Two plane mirror makes an angle 40 degree with each other. How many images are formed if object is kept symmetrically? Object is kept symmetrically. Then how many number of images formed? Okay. First one, student, if object is at symmetrically, that means theta 1 is equal to theta 2. Now, our formula, that is 360 degree by theta. First one, check that 360 degree by theta is an even number or odd number. 360 degree by 40, that is equal to 9. 9 is an odd number. Then if this one is an odd number, then go to the two case. That object is at symmetrical position or asymmetric position. Here that question is, object is at symmetric position. That means theta 1 equals to theta 2. So how many number of images form? That number of images form, the formula, that is 360 degree by theta minus 1. The 360 degree by theta, that is equals to 9. 9 minus 1, that is 8. Now, go to another question. Angle between two plane mirror is 72 degree. So, what is the angle between two plane mirror? That is 72 degree. And object is kept asymmetric. Object is kept asymmetric. How many number of images form? First, you check that 360 degree by theta is an even number or odd number. 360 degree by 72 degree, that is equals to 5. If you got odd number, then check that object is asymmetric or asymmetric. Here that object is asymmetric. So how many number of images formed? That number of images formed, that is 360 degree by theta. The 360 degree by theta, that is equals to 5. So number of images formed, that is equals to 5. So students, in our next class, we discuss the characteristic of image formed by plane mirror and in case of spherical mirror.